Hi everyone! Welcome to this video on getting started with the TreeGrid component from Syncfusion in a Blazor server application. TreeGrid is a feature-rich component used to visualize self-referential hierarchical data effectively in a tabular format. In this video, I'll explain how to create a Blazor server app and install the Syncfusion Blazor package in the app. And then I'll explain how to add Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid component with the required columns to the application. After creating the TreeGrid, I will add prominent features to it, like paging, sorting, and filtering. Now let me proceed to create the Blazor project first. I can create a Blazor application either using Visual Studio 2019 or Visual Studio Code. In this video, I'll create a server-side Blazor application using the Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or later versions. To follow along with this video, one should have a basic understanding of C#, HTML, and CSS. Also, you can watch a descriptive video regarding Blazor and Syncfusion controls with the title, Create a Blazor Server App and Add Syncfusion Blazor Components, which I have shared in the YouTube card on this video. Using Visual Studio 2019, I'll create a new project. I'll select the template, Blazor App. Provide the project name as My Blazor Server App, and click Create. Here, the Blazor Server app was selected by default, hence, I proceed by clicking the Create button. Now, Visual Studio has generated a Blazor Server application. To use the Syncfusion Blazor TreeGrid component, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project file and selecting Manage NuGet Packages. Under the Browse tab, I select the Include Pre-Release checkbox since I am going to use the beta version of Syncfusion Blazor package. I will search for the Syncfusion Blazor package. I select it and click the Install button. The installation has been completed now, and you can check it under the Dependencies folder. And within the Packages folder, you can see the Syncfusion Blazor package added to this application. Next, I will register Syncfusion Blazor service in the services container. For that, I open the startup CS file and use the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Within the configure services method, I make a call to the add Syncfusion Blazor method. This makes Syncfusion Blazor services available within the application. Next, I will register a valid Syncfusion license key. To do so, in the configured method, I call the Syncfusion Licensing Syncfusion License Provider static method register license. You need to pass your Syncfusion license key as a string parameter in the register license method. I have done this off screen. Within the pages folder, open the host.cshtml file. Within the head tag, I need to add the required CSS file to render the Syncfusion Blazor components. In this example, I refer to the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Now let me add the Syncfusion Blazor tree grid in the index.razor page. To do so, I use the Syncfusion Blazor tree grid namespace. Adding this namespace here will allow me to use the tree grid component markup in this index.razor page. Also, I can import this namespace in the imports.razor page to make it available in all Razor pages within the application. I remove the existing code and type an SF TreeGrid tag, as the TreeGrid will not be visible if it has no data in it. I'll create a data source for the TreeGrid. For that, first, I'll create a self-referential, that is, flat data source in C#. Since this is a Razor file, I use the @code directive. I create class business object and add properties, task ID, task name, duration, progress, priority, and parent ID with their respective types. I create a list of business objects, variable named, tree data, and assign a new list of business objects. I override the onInitialize method, which will be called when the component is initialized. And within it, I add items to the tree data list object. In the sftreegrid tag, I set the data source to the tree data list object that we have created just before. Now, I will explain the structure of the flat data used in this example. Here, The task ID field holds a unique value to identify each object in this data collection. So, in the SF TreeGrid tag for the ID mapping property, I will assign the task ID field name. Next comes the parent ID field, with a value that represents the parent node to which it belongs. Here, this value points to the task ID's value of the first object. So, the second object will be considered a child node of the first object. Now I will assign the parent ID mapping property with parent ID field name. In this way, the tree grid ensures that the structure of the data is self-referential, and then it will start to establish the parent-child relationships. To display specific columns and customize them into TreeGrid, you may need to define the needed columns as an array within the TreeGrid column tag. Within the TreeGrid columns tag, I define 5 columns to display in the TreeGrid UI. The field property refers to the columns' names defined in the data source. The header text holds the display text for that column in the TreeGrid. The width property sets the width for that column. The text align aligns the text in the column. By default, columns will be aligned to the left. To change that, say for example on the numeric column type, like this task ID, I have set the value to right instead. I save the file and run the application. You can see the tree grid rendered with the self-referential data. You can see the expand and collapse options is shown in the first column. To display those buttons on the second column of the tree grid, let me add the tree column index property and set its value to 1, which represents the index value of the second column. Now I will save the file and run the application. You can see the tree grid with the expand and collapse buttons displaying in the second column. Next, I will move on to the adding important features to the Blazor tree grid. The tree grid component has a powerful set of features such as paging, sorting, filtering, and many more. I'll explain how to add the paging, sorting, and filtering features now. To enable paging, in the SF TreeGrid tag, add the property allow paging and set its value to true. Now I will save the file and run the application. You can see the TreeGrid with a pager at the bottom showing all of the data. You can customize the pager using the page settings property. To do this, I add the TreeGrid page settings tag. Add the page size mode property and set the value to root. Then I add the page size property and set the value to 2 so that I can show a maximum of 2 root nodes in each page. With the page size mode property set to root, only the root level or the zero level records are considered in a records count. Now I will save the file and run the application. In the tree grid, you can see only the 2 root nodes in the first page, and the third root node on the second page. Now let's move on to the sorting feature. To enable sorting, in the SF TreeGrid tag, add the property allow sorting and set its value to true. Now I'll save the file and run the application. Clicking on the progress column header sorts it in ascending order. I again click on the progress header, and now it'll set in descending order. You can also sort the columns at the initial load. To do this, I add the TreeGrid sort setting tag, and within it, I add the TreeGrid sort columns tag, as well as the TreeGrid sort column tag. I set the field property to progress and direction to descending. In the same way, I add the duration column and set its direction as ascending. Now I save the file and run the application. In the TreeGrid, you can see the progress column sorted in descending order and duration column sorted in ascending order as assigned, and their orders are updated to numbers 1 and 2, respectively. Next, I'll proceed with filtering feature. To enable filtering, in the SF TreeGrid tag, add the property allow filtering and set its value to true. Now I save the file and run the application. You can see the tree grid with the default filter bar enabled. In the task column filter bar, I type the expression parent, and now the tree grid displays only the matching records. There are other customizing options available in filtering, which I'll cover in an upcoming video. If you need more information about the Blazor tree grid component, you can refer to our online documentation link provided in the below description. Finally, let me summarize the main points. I've explained the steps to create a Blazor server app project and import the Syncfusion Blazor package. Then I explain how to add Blazor TreeGrid component to the application, along with a few important details. You can download this featured example from the link provided in the below description. If you found this video is useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications for our new videos. Thanks for watching.